Good morning all. Today we will see the basic principle of NMR and what is shielding and deshielding in HO1 NMR. So first of all, the basic principle of HO1 NMR is when the radio frequency is used to excite the nucleus, then it becomes exactly equal to the precessional energy of that nucleus, and then we called it as the formation of a resonance, and the nucleus absorb to get an excited state, and this is known as the NMR. We'll see this how it works. For this we have to consider a proton, that is a hydrogen. So we all know that hydrogen, it has in a nucleus there is one proton and neutron. So neutrons are neutral, that's why we consider the proton with positive charge. So the proton, they are continuously under motion or they are circulating, that's why it act as a tiny bar magnet, with small bar magnet. So consider this magnet as this, it has two poles, south pole and north pole. We can show in our explanation magnet like this. So only two states are possible over here. One is upward and downward, north pole and south pole. So in physics we have already learned that if two same poles, they are coming closer, then there is a repulsion, and when they are opposite poles they are coming, there is a attraction. So this shows that one magnet can affect the orientation of other magnet, right? So this is the basic which is used in the H1 NMR. So again, consider this magnet. This magnet is there, but when the other magnet come in contact with it, there is its spin or its orientation changes, and the result is like this. So this is the basic of NMR. How the NMR works, this is explained by using the magnet. Again, here this magnet, we can call it as a magnet. Now this is the magnet in the magnetic field, and when we put this magnet in the NMR, this is an NMR machine. So NMR machine is having a magnet. So when we start the magnetic field, we call it as an external magnetic field. So it will start like this, and this magnet, it will orient on the same side or along with the external magnetic field, then it will look like this. This is the before external magnetic field, this is the magnet, and this magnet is after external magnetic field. This is the basic. Now when this such phenomenon is happening, they are in the alpha state. On the same side, this is called as the alpha state with lower energy, and they are the on same side. But what happens when there is a magnet, you can give the external magnetic field, it is a possibility or it is a chance that it will not goes along that external magnetic field, or it can oppose. So that time we called it as a beta spin state with the high energy. These two energies we can show like this. Now what is there in actual in H1 NMR machine, which can be considered here for explaining shielding and deshielding phenomena. Consider two magnet. One magnet is with the here, there are no electrons, but in another magnet there are few electrons are there. So when we start the machine with external magnetic field, this spin orients like this, and when we give the external magnetic field, that is RF radio frequency radiation is passed to this, then the spin of this particular magnet, it get reverse. So this much energy is required here. Let us consider that energy is as a E1 and this spin state as a A. Here when we use the radio frequency to this magnet, here are the electrons, so its spin does not changes, and it will get a RF radiation, it will change its direction only this much distance. This will be called as a, this is the spin which is opposing, and it will be E2. So we can easily see here E1 is you have to move this much distance, so E1 is greater than E2. Now, if you put this both the nuclei in the same direction, that we called it as a resonance, right? Resonance means the same. So here, from that graph, we can see E1 is greater than E2. So if you plot the graph starting from 0, energy on x-axis, E1 is greater than E2, A and B. So this is nothing but the shielding and deshielding. How? If we put these two magnets in NMR, we will get a spectrum like this. Two protons are in two different environments. B is shielded by the electrons and other is deshielded. This can be explained from this example. This is the ethyl chloride. So chlorine is electronegative, can pull the electrons toward itself from the CH2, and this CH2, it will get a less electron, so we called it as a deshielded, and that's why we'll see the peak on the deshielded side.